today we are discussing about the human heart. The human heart has got four chambers. These are the right atrium, right ventricle, left atrium. It is in the base. It is identified by the presence of four pulmonary veins and left ventricle. Now we will see the other surfaces of the heart. Apex of the heart. Apex of the heart is formed entirely by the left ventricle. It is directed downwards, forwards and to the left and is overlapped by the anterior border of the left lung. It is situated in the left fifth intercostal space 9 cm lateral to the midsternal line, just medial to the midclavicular line. Base of the heart. Base of the heart is also called its posterior surface. It is formed mainly by the left atrium and by a small part of the right atrium. In relation to the base, you can see the openings of four pulmonary veins which open into the left atrium and of the superior and inferior vena cava which open into the right atrium. Next, we will see the borders of the heart. Now we will continue to study the borders of the heart in its anatomical position. The upper border is slightly oblique and is formed by the two atria, chiefly by the left atrium. The right border is more or less vertical and is formed by the right atrium. It extends from superior vena cava to inferior vena cava. The inferior border is nearly horizontal and is formed mainly by the left right ventricle. A small part of it near the apex is formed by left ventricle. It extends from the interventricular septum to apex. The left border is oblique and curved. It is formed mainly by the left ventricle and partly by the left auricle. It separates the anterior and left surfaces of the heart. Now we will see the surfaces of the heart. The anterior or sternocostal surface is formed mainly by the right atrium and right ventricle and partly by the left atrium and left auricle. The left atrium is not seen on the anterior surface as it is covered by the aorta and pulmonary trunk. Most of the sternocostal surface is covered by the lungs, but a part of it that lies behind the cardiac notch of the left lung is uncovered. The inferior or diaphragmatic surface rests on the central tendon of the diaphragm. It is formed in its left two-thirds by the left ventricle and in its right one-third by the right ventricle. It is transversed by the posterior interventricular groove and is directed downwards and slightly backwards. The left surface is formed mostly by the left ventricle and at the upper end by the left auricle. In its upper part, the surface is crossed by coronary sulcus. Now we will see the grooves or sulci on the heart. The atria are separated from the ventricles by a circular atrioventricular or anterior coronary sulcus, which is divided into anterior and posterior parts. Anterior part consists of right and left halves. Right half is oblique between right auricle and right ventricle, lodging right coronary artery. Left part is small between left auricle and left ventricle, lodges circumflex branch of left coronary artery. Here we can see the posterior part of coronary sulcus. It lodges the left coronary circumflex part of left coronary artery. The coronary sulcus is overlapped anteriorly by the ascending aorta and the pulmonary trunk. The interatrial groove is faintly visible posteriorly. You can see the interatrial groove between the two atria. It is visible faintly. While anteriorly, it is hidden by the aorta and pulmonary trunk. The anterior interventricular groove is near to the left margin of the heart. It runs downwards and to the left. The lower end of the groove separates the apex from the rest of the inferior border of the heart. The posterior interventricular groove is situated on the diaphragmatic or inferior surface of the heart. It is nearer to the right margin of this surface. The true interventricular grooves meet at the inferior border near the apex. normally clinical anatomy, normally the cardiac apex or apex beat is on the left side. In the condition called dextrocardia, the apex is on the right side. Dextrocardia may be a part of condition called situs inversus, in which all thoracic and abdominal viscera are a mirror image of normal.